Hey, all you crazy cat and kittens, Mr. Immedio here, and I am going to be reintroducing Naviance to you all. Naviance is something that you all created an account last year in ninth grade seminar with your school counselor. For those who are new to Newton North or don't remember this, you should just reach out to your school counselor about setting up a Naviance account. So I want to get right into this. So I'm going to, how do you get to Naviance? So you're going to go to the Newton North homepage, and this is the easiest, the best way to get back to Naviance or to access it. And Naviance can be accessed through your phone and through any browser. So you, when you get to the North website, you're going to scroll over to counseling and go about five tabs down to Naviance. When you click there, we'll be brought to the login screen. When you get to the login screen, you are going to be able to choose four options. Five if you're new. For all intents and purposes for this, you are going to choose the student tab. For those who may be watching that are parent or guardian, you can choose the guest tab, and the password is Tiger, all lowercase. If you are new to and need to register, again, reach out to your school counselor, get your access code. Once you get the access code and put that in, you will be able to create an account. So I'm going to log in as a student. If you're using a personal device, so your Chromebook, your own laptop, your phone, I recommend remembering your password just so you can have easy access, easy login every time you want to use Naviance. Because the reality is now that we're in the middle of 10th grade, you're going to be using Naviance a lot more than you did in 9th grade. And you're going to continue using it through 11th grade as more features begin to open up. So keep that password handy if you don't remember it or you don't have your computer remember it. So I'm going to click continue, get logged in here. You see welcome sophomores, tailored to my name right there. So the first things I want to kind of draw your attention to very quickly, because this is going to be a very brief overview of Naviance. You can watch a more in-depth version that will be an email going home momentarily. So those who are looking for summer opportunities, job listings, internships, if you scroll down to the bottom of the Naviance page, you'll see that here. So you can find job listings. Ms. McElroy, she is in the career and tech ed department. She often updates this as of this recording. This is the 26th, and she updated this yesterday. So scroll through there for lots of local opportunities for jobs. In terms of summer listings and summer opportunities, lots of various pre-college programs are listed here. They can range anywhere from an academic aspect to more of a creative, more fun aspect, as you can see with like Project Fashion, game experience. So scroll through there. Know that these cost money. However, most do have financial assistance with the programs. That's all up to you if you want to participate in something like that. It is not required by any college or university or employer that you participate in a pre-college summer program. Do what makes sense for you. So now what I want to draw your attention to in the upper right corner, I'm going to draw your attention to some of the interest inventories and the free kind of features that are now available to sophomores via Naviance. So if you go into the About Me tab, scroll down to My Assessments. Here in My Assessments, you're going to find six kind of like quizzes, so to speak. Some of them are a little longer than the other, some a little shorter. So I just want to briefly show you a few of these. If you watch the longer video, you'll kind of go more, I'll go a little bit more in depth. So do what you are. This is an interest inventory, helps figure out who you are as a learner, who you are as a person, and things you might want to explore in the summer, things you might want to explore in your future. These assessments are super quick in the sense of how you answer. There's no writing component. It's usually a this or that, a rating scale, choosing what you like, what you don't like, if you like something unsure, dislike something, things like that. Once you click an answer, it immediately goes to the next question. Once you get through that, you'll get your results. The only people who can see your results are you. Parents can see them if you are sharing an account with your parents, of course, but then your school counselor can see some of them as well through our side of Naviance. But it's a great opportunity for you to have conversations with your school counselor about these interest inventories. So we have that Do What You Are, then we have the Multiple Intelligence Advantage, Learning Style Inventory, the Strength Explorer, the Career Interest Profiler, and the Career Cluster Finder. So play around with those when you have that time, whether you're waiting for your dentist appointment or you're sitting in the SOA between classes. Great time to kind of play around with some of these features of Naviance, because it can help kind of shape courses you take next year, internships that you sign up for, volunteer experiences that you participate in, anything like that. If you go to the careers tab, two things that are kind of interesting, just the career clusters pathways. You can look up all different careers for the sake of time. I'm going to throw in education right here. Actually, I'm going to throw in elementary education just to narrow down our search. So I want to be an elementary school teacher, and I am going to click right here. And as you see this, and you can type this in for various different occupations, you can also use one of the drop-down boxes to kind of generalize what you're looking for. So an overview of the job, the knowledge and skills required for the job, the tasks and activities that come up with being an elementary school teacher. And then what's kind of interesting to me is the wages. So the national averages of the wages as a teacher and what you'd make if you stayed in the state of Massachusetts. So you can do this for all different careers right through Naviance. And that might help kind of guide you as you think of life after high school, because the reality is in 2 short years, high school will be ending and your time at Newton North will be coming to a close and you'll be creating a future for yourself. So whatever that looks like, it's good to kind of use this career cluster to help guide you. In addition to life after high school, whatever it may be, whether you're applying to a college, applying to a job, applying to a gap year program, the military, they might require something called a resume. So if you go to the About Me tab, scroll down to My Stuff and go to resume, you can see how to incorporate a resume into Naviance. So you click this little pink button. You choose what you want to add. For what I've already added here is my educational experience and my my participation in the Super Smash Brothers Club. I'm a huge Kirby fan, gamer, you know, but all those kids in the club can beat me. So I guess I'm not that good. Once you do that and add everything that you need, you can go to print and export the resume. I just did this a little while ago. And you can choose the resume out layout that you want. You can choose what you want on the resume. It will also include your personal information, as in like your address, your email address, anything like that. And you can print it as a PDF or a Microsoft Word document. And you can use all of that as you prepare for summer programs, life after high school. So this is a great feature and definitely something to take advantage of. So that is about it for Naviance. It's a very quick overview of it. Talk to your school counselor, whether it be me or anyone else. Have conversations with your parents about this and kind of play around with the features. Be kind of fun sometimes. So I thank you for listening. Have a wonderful day and be well. See ya.